everyone. Welcome back to Evolution of a Woman with your girl, Shawnee Fenderson. I know you hear a little noise in the background. That's the air conditioner. excuse me, even in the fall, even in the winter, I have to have some sort of air blowing. You know, I guess the older we get as females, the more we have to have air blowing because we have hot flashes. But anyway, I wanted to talk today about something that I've done, and I'm sure a lot of other women have done it as well, that idea of trying to get somebody to look at you, especially a man. You know, we always have that, well, maybe if I wear this certain outfit, he'll see me. Maybe if I wear this certain perfume, he'll smell me. Maybe if I have my hair done a certain way, he'll look at me and he'll think, you know, oh, she's nice. And like I say, I've been guilty of it. I really wanted somebody to recognize me. And the more I tried, the more they hated me. The more I tried, the more they ran the opposite direction. And you find that often. And it's really not their fault. You know, it's not their fault at all. First of all, we were trained. First of all, we were trained as not even trained just yet. I would say as little kids, you know, we're wanting to please our parents. We're wanting to say, Mom, look what I could do, or Dad, look what I could do. Look at, I did this. And it's like a sense of an accomplishment. Once they say, oh, yay, you know, when they do it with toddlers, the little toddler walks to you and they go, hey, good job, good job. From there, it goes even further. We're in school and we're wanting to receive that same recognition, this time from our teacher. So what are we doing? We're, when they ask a question, we're like, ooh, 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 raising our hand up real high. And, you know, we're flagging them down like they could see us, you know, just trying to get their attention. We're hopping up and down. Look, 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 I got the answer. And still, most times, the teacher will pick the one that's silent instead of the one that is obnoxious and the one that's screaming for attention. Now, when we get into high school, we're trying to figure out who we are, but still, we're now trying to please, instead of the teacher, we're trying to please our peers, and we're trying to get attention of the boys in the hallway. You know, it has changed. Now, actually, this has gone to middle school. Kind of sad to say, but anyway, they're wanting to get the guys' attention. So we'll pick up magazines, we'll watch videos, we'll listen to our friends, we'll do any and everything just to get the guys' attention. We'll sleep with them. And yes, high school, middle school, junior high, these young girls are sleeping with the guys. We'll sleep with them. We'll commence to do oral. And on one of the shows that I did, what was it, a girl received STD under her arms, and she was in junior high. But we're doing things that we never thought we would do before in order to get the guy's attention. We're saying, look at me, look at me. What was that on Mad TV? There was this one character, look what I could do. Anyway, that's how basically we end up being in high school. From high school, now we're in college. We have, we're picking the, you know, the most prestigious background that we could have so that not only our parents will look at us and say, oh, what an accomplishment, but also our peers will look at us and say, what an accomplishment. Also ourselves, so we can say, look what kind of accomplishment I have made or what I have done. And then when it comes time to dating, We're looking for someone who has the same background, who's also wanting to accomplish something, who feels that they are proud with the decisions that they made in their lives and their education and their and we're noticing that the men around us are also looking for accomplishments, and eventually they'll want to settle down, but in the process we're trying to again please them. We're trying to say, look at what I've done. I have now a bachelor's degree. I have my home. I'm an educated person who is a professional, no longer a paraprofessional, but now a professional, making some cases 5 figures, some cases 6 figures. But all of it is saying, look at me. And again, we can't say that it's the guy's fault. It's us. And the more that we start shouting, look, 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 they can see a mile and a half away that you're not even worth looking at. They could recognize that you're not about who you say you are. They could recognize that you really are more concerned with accomplishments rather than home, rather than, and when I say home, I don't mean home as far as being able to purchase things for the home, home as far as being able to go out and say, I own this home. It's more about the home, which is in the heart and in the mind. That's what they're thinking of when they're wanting to be with someone after their accomplishments. But we as women, we tend to want to push further and further and further. And the more things that we have under our belt, the more we'll feel satisfied in believing that we've accomplished something. You know, at age 34, I should have a house. I should have preparations, be prepared for being married. At 37, I should have one child, the home, the husband, and everything is hunky-dory. At age 40, we now have 3 kids. We've moved to the burbs. We have 2 in school, 1 baby. All of this while we're juggling work and more accomplishments and more goals and more standards that we set for ourselves, and also what society set for us, and also the lies that we've heard time and time again. No one will pay attention to you if you truly do not have it together spiritually. That's just really how it is. Regardless of how pretty you look, how much makeup you have on, how much you spend on your clothes or your car, the upkeep on the exterior, no one will pay attention to you because they know it's all a show. They know that you're that child in the classroom making an idiot of himself, herself, jumping up and down just to prove a point. You know what the guys are really looking at? They're looking at the girl who was silent. They're peeping the entire thing. They're peeping everything that's out there. But they're looking at the girl that's silent, just like a teacher in a classroom. They're looking at the one who's seems to be not so blatantly aggressive. They're looking at the one who's a thinker. And, you know, she's not as obnoxious as the other ones. She's cute, kind of, but she's not as wild as the other ones. She's not as loud as the other ones. She's not as ghetto. You know what I'm saying? All of these things that we think we should be for a guy, that's not what they're looking for. All of the ways that we try to feel that we should please the guy, that's not what they're looking for either. I mean, come on, think about it. How many times have you slept with somebody and done everything you never thought you would do, and you're still not with them? How many times have you gone out and did everything under the sun as far as proving that you could be wife material, and you're still not with them? It's something about you and your character, something about me and my character that says you need to be more quiet. You need to sit back and be silent instead of being the obnoxious, loud female screaming for attention. Your focus, of course, needs to be on study, which is what that quiet little girl in the classroom did. Focus was on study. Focus was on getting herself prepared for something different, something better. Not concerned about who's looking at her. Not concerned with bullies, but focused. And that's how we need to be as women, is focused. And yeah, you know, a lot of these videos you are going to see me choked up, because like I said, I've been silent for a while because growth was taking place. So if I begin crying, my eyes get all watery, you'll know why. Anywho, remain focused. True, not everyone will be promised someone at the time that they expected. With the ratio of men to women, some women will be single. But without thinking of all of that, remain focused. Don't be the obnoxious person. And I know it's kind of hard for me to say because I'm an author and a poet and a photographer and I'm always out there. But, and a talker. But there's a moment when we have to sit back and let things take its course. Love you lots, ladies. If you have any questions, inbox me, MAYLODI at yahoo.com. Also here on YouTube. If you're on Twitter, you can find me at twitter.com/MAYLODI. And also on Facebook, Shawnee Fenderson, the author, my group page. And you know what, ladies, this is a struggle. Again, I told you this yesterday, it's not easy. It's a struggle. And sometimes you have to go through the storm and dig deep and recognize what it is that you're going through, why you're going through it, and praise in the process, you know, because eventually what needs to happen will happen. Love you lots. Smooches.